Meth. How much power will it give you? You'll be surprised by the answer. Hey, what's up, guys? In this episode, we're going to talk about meth injection. But first, be sure to subscribe. And if you want more content, check out our Patreon page. All right, I see this question quite a bit on forums and on Facebook. And the question is, what gains will I see if I use meth injection? Or more commonly, how much power will meth give me? If you just want a quick answer, it's absolutely nothing. But you already know meth injection is used for power, so why do I say you won't see any gains? Well, let's start off with what meth injection really is. Now, when you hear the term meth injection, it's usually referring to water plus methanol. Methanol, or meth, is a type of alcohol. It's commonly mixed with water at various concentrations and injected into engines. And why? Well, the obvious answer is for performance reasons. Injecting the mixture has a cooling effect on the incoming air, which reduces combustion temps and helps prevent or suppress knock due to heat. Of course, cooler air also helps increase potential power. Generally, because of this cooling effect, you can run more boost without needing to upgrade the intercooler, and it may allow you to run boost without an intercooler depending on your setup. Now, because meth is an alcohol, it has a high octane rating, so in addition to cooling, it also increases the overall resistance to knock, which means that you can run more timing, which is important for naturally aspirated engines. Water and meth injection can also help clean and keep clean your engine and components. Now, your results will vary on this depending on your mileage and how well you've taken care of your engine to begin with. Don't expect squeaky clean engine internals after only one bottle, though. It usually takes quite a while. So, if there are so many benefits to meth injection, why do I say you won't see any gains? Well, just installing a kit on your car will not give you any power gains, and in fact, you're more likely to see a loss in power. You won't see any power gains without tuning for it, or if your build already has a need for it. Methanol is a fuel. Adding a fuel to your combustion process will richen up your air-fuel ratio. Now, from the factory, most cars already run pretty rich, so a loss of power is inevitable. Water is going to delay the combustion process, which is similar to retarding the timing, and removing timing generally results in lost power. This is where the tuning comes in. The size of the nozzle and the mixture used will play a role in what happens both tuned and untuned. When setting up your kit, you choose between various sizes of spray nozzles, each rated at a certain cc per minute or milliliter per minute. Some manufacturers refer to their nozzles directly by flow rate, such as 125 cc, 250 cc, etc. And some companies use nozzle codes like number 1, number 4, or DO1, DO5, and so on. But each nozzle still represents a specific flow rate. You'll need a size accordingly based on your setup and your goals. When it comes to water and meth injection, more isn't always better. For NA applications, you can expect to lose power no matter what you do. Sorry, it just won't happen. I've tested several setups and all resulted in a loss without tuning for it. Now, if you're using a small enough nozzle and running water or a very low ratio of meth to water on a boosted application, you could possibly see minor gains by helping to keep the intake air temperatures down or help with knock if you've increased the boost with a boost controller. But we're talking a few horsepower at best. So in general, you should expect to lose power unless you tune for it. Okay, so what gains will you get if you do tune for meth? Well, anywhere from 0 horsepower to 1,000,000 horsepower. Seriously, it all depends on your build, the way you set up your kit, and your tuner. Your best option is to talk with your tuner about your build and what you're looking to achieve, and they will help you configure your kit accordingly. So in conclusion, installing meth injection on your car just for the fun of it is a bad idea. You'll need a custom tune to utilize meth injection and get the most from it. All right, that's it for this episode. Be sure to subscribe, and if you like this video, click that like button or leave a comment below. Thanks for watching.